Hello.
Hey guys. Nice to see you again. As we said in our last video, today we will talk about functions in TwinCAT 3.
This will be a lot of fun.
Hee hee hee.
In your project tree, a function POU has the suffix fun.
Hee hee.
A function returns exactly one data element when executed. This data element can be a single value, an array, or a structure, depending on the specific needs of your program. In contrast to a function block, the function can't hold state. All variables declared in a function are temporary and only valid during the execution of the function. This implies that TwinCAT reinitializes all the data of the function every time it is called. Function calls can be used in text-based programs to make them more modular. If you create a fresh new function, TwinCAT will ask you for a name and a return type. The name of the function should ideally describe what the function does. The return type defines and constrains the data type of the value returned from the function.
Let's create a new function. Therefore, click on POU, Add, POU, and select Function. Choose a name for it and select a return type. We call our function countBananas. Because we want it to count bananas and select int as type. The editor of the function consists of two parts, the declaration part, which defines the parameters and data types for the function, and the implementation part, which contains the actual logic and calculations performed by the function. In the top line of the declaration part, you can see the name of the function and its return type. Below, you can declare the input and function variables.
Note, a function call with the same input values should always result in the same output value. Do not use global variables and addresses within functions to ensure that the function behaves consistently and predictably. Also important to know, if you declare a local variable in a function as retain, this has no effect. In this case, TwinCAT issues a compiler error. The output variable of a function is the function name. But optionally, you can define output variables and variables that are inputs and outputs at the same time. To declare them, you need to add var output or var in out in the declaration part.
Let's have a look at our examples. We have some boxes filled with bananas. The boxes are represented as arrays of type int in the main program. These arrays, we will hand over to the functions. A first function will give us the total amount of bananas in one array. A second function will sort the arrays, starting with the smallest value. After using the second function, we will work with the new sorted boxes in our main program. Let us declare our first function. All our shelves in the warehouse have space for 6 boxes. We declare an array with 6 elements of type int as input variable. You can, of course, declare more than one input variable. We also need a local variable that we will use as an index. We call it I of type int. We write in the implementation part for I equals 1 to 6 do count bananas equals count bananas plus amount. In square brackets I. Count bananas is initialized with 0 by default. We close with end for.
Now we go back to the main program. We declare another local variable of type int and call it total amount. In the implementation part we write total amount equals. Now we call the function. Let's explore an example of a function call. You can just call the function. Write the name of the function and behind it an open and a closed bracket. That will simply give you the return value of the function. Additionally, and depending on what the function does, you can assign inputs in the brackets. The output is the name of your function. The output, or extra outputs you declared in the function, can be assigned like this. So, in our case, we will do the following. We use our function and in brackets we assign the first array to the input of the function. Next, we want to add the total amount of the second array. To do so we write, plus and call the function again, this time we assign our second array to the input. Let's log in and start the program. As return value, we get back the sum that was calculated in our function.
And just like that, we have the total amount of all bananas.
Now let us declare the second function, we call it sortBananas. As input variable we will use again an array.
Yeknam, I would suggest changing the var input to varinout, because, if we use an array as input variable, the function makes a copy of the array and works with this copy. That means, the values in our functions will change, but the values in the main program will not. A variable, declared as varinout, works differently. Variables of this type can be both read and written. When the function is called, the inout variable is passed to the actual variable as an argument. This means that no copy is created at runtime, and instead, the variable receives a reference to the actual variable that is assigned to it. The internal value of referential variables is a memory address that points to the actual value. Therefore, any changes made to the inout variable will also be reflected in the original variable. This can be useful when you want to modify the original variable within a function or method.
Yes, that is a good advice, Ajnan. Also, we can use an array with variable length now. If you want to know more about arrays, we recommend watching the video we made about the topic. Let's declare it. We need some other variables for our sorter. We will use a bubble sort algorithm. I have typed int, this will be the index of the array. Temp of type int, this is a variable which temporarily stores a value of an array element. Check done of type bool. And already done of type dint, initialized with 1.
We start with a repeat loop. If you want to learn more about loops, watch the video we created about this topic. It is shown in the upper right corner. The checkDone variable is used as condition to exit the loop. In the line after the repeat, we write setCheckDone to false. And after the until we write notCheckDone as exit condition. Next we use a for loop, which runs from the lower to the upper bound. Already done is incremented every time one array element is on its final position. The value is deducted from the upper bound. After the do, we start an if instruction. If the condition is true, the elements are swapped. Check done equals true, this line is needed to prevent the exit condition of the repeat loop from becoming true until everything is sorted correctly. After the end for, already done gets increased. So, that's our sorter. At the end we assign already done to our function output. Sometimes it's interesting to know how often the array went through the sorter. Sort bananas equals already done.
Let's go back to the main and call the sorter function there. To make it a little more exciting, let's add the elements of our two arrays. The box with the highest number of bananas from one array is added to the box with the lowest number of bananas from the other array. Therefore, we declare 4 new variables. I and j of type int, as index for the arrays. J is initialized with 7. A new array, called new shelf of type int. Also we declare an variable of type dint and call it how often. This variable will get the return value of our function. And we need a bool variable for an if instruction we are going to use later. How often equals sort bananas, in brackets, banana boxes equals shelf 1, this line calls the function and assigns our array to the varinout variable. Also, we assign the return value of the function to how often. And again, for the other array. Next, we write the part in which our array elements get added. Now we pass the new shelf array to the sortBanana function. Because we can. At the end we put an if instruction around this entire block, because we want the code only to be executed once. Let's log in and start the program. We set start to true. As you can see, our function sorted the arrays. And the values are changed in the arrays in the main.
Now, you know the basics of how to work with functions.
We will make another video that deals with the topic of structures and references in connection with functions. So stay tuned.
Have a great time, hit the bell, visit our company's website or our LinkedIn profile. Bye bye, banana.
Bye.